Hey guys, it's Megan. Looking forward to this pyramid we're gonna be working on today. You'll need a set of heavy weights, a set of light weights. I'll also be using a mat. So you might want a mat, sweat towel, water, and let's get started. And get my timer ready. Hope everyone's doing good today and ready to go. All right. Here we go. All right. Chair pose. We're standing up, squeeze, and down. Pulling the hips forward. Tighten the glutes. Find that pull with the arms. Sit back into the heels. Let's add a knee lift. Up. Working on getting the knee up towards the chest. Taking it to a kick. Here we go. Just the kick. Working on flexibility, getting the heart rate up. Take it to a knee, cross opposite elbow. Hold that right knee up, get a little hug. Circles back. Three, two, one. Set it down. Hold the left knee up. Three circles back. Three, two, one. Come into your second position. Down and up. Take it to the corners of the room. Hold it center, down and up. Four, three, two, one. Pull, pull. You have eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Nice job. Okay, our first exercise for our pyramid is the inchworm push-up. So you'll start, if you're using a mat, the back of your mat, you'll have your weights in your hands, squat down, set the weights down, walk forward, one push-up, walk the hands back, get into that squat, then stand and lift. All right? Grab your weights, I'm using 20s. Here we go. Seconds of this one. Go for a full range push-up. All your break. Our next exercise is a plank pull through. I'm gonna use a 20 as well. I'm gonna have the 20 on the outside of my body. I'm gonna grab with the opposite arm, set it over. Opposite arm, set it over. You wanna make sure your hips stay square and steady. Try not to rotate at all through the torso. We're starting with our inchworm push-ups. Here we go. So not only is this one working on strength, it's also working on flexibility through those hamstrings. Got a little cardio action by walking the hands forward and back. All right, we're to the plank. One weight to the outside. Opposite arm. Pull it under, take it wide. Pull it under, take it wide. Keep that core strong, navel to spine. My legs are pretty wide to help with keeping my hips square. Break. Our next one is a burpee to back fly. So you can take those weights down, jump back, jump in, and then give me a back fly. You're squeezing the shoulder blades together as you open up the chest. Okay? Grab your weights for the inchworm. And here we go. Make sure you squeeze and press the hips forward when you come up. I'm going down to my chest on that push-up. You can always drop your knees. Good form. All right, I'm to my plank. Take that weight pretty wide, so you really have to reach for it. Keep those hips square. All right, we're doing our burpees. Grab your weights. Drop them down. Jump back, jump in, and back fly. Pulling it. Keep the hips square. Hip points facing the floor. All right, which are your burpees. right. We're going into a plank with those weights. Wide leg. You're pulling the weight to the hip pocket and switching. No push-up in between because we did that with the inchworm push-ups. All right, inchworm push-up. Let's go. Full range. Go for depth. Working your obliques. Burpee to back fly. Grab those weights. Oh, I did two back flies. Let's do two back flies. Let's make it two as we get more in. All right, set it down. You've got bridge to a narrow chest press. Exhale on the way up. 10 seconds. Don't be afraid to go heavy here. And break. All right, so the next exercise is the other leg. So my right leg will be forward. And we'll take it to a three-quarter lift because I have heavies. I'm only gonna take it up as my muscles allow me to do. So it won't come all the way up. It'll be quarter to three-quarter, halfway around there. All right, inchworm. Here we go. Burpee to back fly. Remember, we're doing two back fly. Because I have that right to change it. Two back fly. You go. We got the Renegade Rose. Work to the hip pocket. All right. We have our split squat. Left leg forward first. Really work on getting those hamstrings. Try not to bend the knees so much. All right, plank. Wide. Weights. Two, burpee back fly. Bridge pose, narrow chest press. Switch legs. Lateral lift. Keep that core brace. 5 seconds. One for lighter weights. Grab on my 10. I'm on the floor. Wide elbows. Start to flutter. Then lift. Keep the low back down. I'm lifting my chest up as I push the weights up. Keep pressing that low back towards the floor. Yeah, to our lunges or our split squat. Right leg's forward first. After this. All right, renegade rows. Take it to the hip pocket. Take it to the back, then narrow chest press. Lift the hips. Burpee to two back flows coming up. Here we go. Take those weights wide. Grab it and pull. Last time for this exercise. Lateral left. Switch. Bicep curl. Renegade rows after this. All right, renegade rows. Bridge to narrow chest press. Woo! Get those hips up there. You got a burpee to back flies. One more. All right, come on up. Burpee to back flies. Last time for this one. Rows. My bad. One more. Okay, now we're bridge. Chest press. Last one for this. You go. Watch that front knee. Don't let it go past the toes. Renegade Rose. Last time for Renegade Rose. Woo! Egyptians could carry all those bricks. We can do a pyramid workout. Here we go. Keep pressing the low back down. Yeah. 20 pound just rolled away. Come on, 10 seconds. Stay with it. Who are you strong for? Break. Oh my gosh. We did it. And my 20 pound rolled all the way over there. All right, come on up. And let's just do a little tap and sway. Swing. Woo! Oh, that feels good, doesn't it? So good to know that we are done. Oh, you know, sometimes I gotta make myself do it. It's really about discipline. It's too easy to not do it, you know? It's too easy to sit in my chair and binge watch Homeland. But you stay with it, you show me your discipline, you're going to reap the benefits, and then it's gonna get to the point where you want to work out. You want that endorphin release. All right. Let's take it wide. Woo! Cross one arm over and hook. And change our music up. Oh, here we go. Here we go. All right, let's switch arms. Feels so good. All right, let's open up the chest. Push the palms back. Bend the elbows. Push back some more. Lift the arm straight overhead. Bend the left elbow. Pull the elbow behind the head. So the discipline, the workout, each individual one, is kind of like the kindling of a fire, right? If you don't have the baby sticks and the small stuff to catch the flame, then the logs are never going to burn, right? Let's open it up. Clasp the hands, drive the knuckles down, open up the chest. But if you have the small stuff, and the discipline of finding the kindling first, let's take a quad stretch. Each workout is stick, little twig by twig. And then before you know it, you've set yourself up for a blazing fire. You've caught hold of this fire to work out, to stay consistent, to exercise your body, your mind, your spirit. Let's switch legs. So stay with the discipline of it. It starts as the discipline, but then it becomes the fuel that kind of fires your internal flame. That kind of is the ricochet of all the other aspects of your life. All right, release. Let's take the legs wide, pull forward, release the head and neck. Bend the knees, bring the hands to the thighs, lift the chest. Exhale, round that, roll it up. Roll the shoulders back.
Activity completed.
Give me one big inhale. And exhale, heart center. Great job. So proud of you. Way to stay with the discipline of it. Let's keep this fire burning. Have a good one.